Good morning, students. So today we are going to start chapter 10 of our NCERT book, and that is microbes in human welfare. So students, in this chapter we are going to study about the various roles of microbes that they have done for human welfare. So in this chapter we are going to study about the role of microorganisms in the production of household products. Then we see their role in large scale production of certain products and industries. Then after this we will study about the antibiotics. These are the special type of chemicals or drugs which are obtained from microorganisms, and they cure various types of deadly diseases that are found in humans as well as animals. Microorganisms, they are also playing important role in the production of an eco-friendly gas, biogas, and how they play this role, that we will study. And in the last, we studied two very important topics, that how the microorganisms, they behave as biocontrol agents, and how these microorganisms, they are also acting as the biofertilizers. So all of these things we will study in this chapter. Okay, students, now we start our chapter. Microbes in human welfare. Okay, student, what is given in the introduction of the chapter? That microorganisms or microbes, they are the important components of our biological system. Though we do not focus on them, we generally found various type of macroscopic organisms such as plants and animals. But these microorganisms, which are only seen under the microscope, they are also the major components of our biological system. So if we are talking about where these are present, so these microbes or microorganisms, they are cosmopolitan in nature. They are present everywhere, wherever we see, in soil, in water, in air, inside our body also, and in the body of plants and animals too. So they are even live in harsh climatic conditions where the life of other organisms is not possible at all. They are easily survive in deep geysers where the temperature is above 100 degrees Celsius. They can easily live in deeper zones of our soil under the layers of snow, which is several meters thick. And they can also successfully survive in the acidic environment too. Okay, student, here the picture of various type of microorganisms are visible to you. They may be categorized as bacteria, viruses, fungi, and other type of microbes. So here you can see the picture of different type of bacteria. You know that there are different kind of bacteria according to their shape. They may be coccus type of bacteria, spirillums, vibrio type of bacteria, or comma shaped bacteria. So according to their shapes, we have named these bacteria. Okay, student, viruses are another type of microorganisms. You know very well the structure of these viruses, that they have two components. One is the protein core, which is made up of capsid. You can call it as capsid, and this capsid is made up of very, very small units known as capsomeres, if you remember. And beside this protein coat, a nucleic acid is present. This nucleic acid may be DNA or RNA. And on the basis of this nucleic acid, these may be DNA viruses or RNA viruses. So you know very well that RNA viruses, they are also known as retroviruses. And by the process of reverse transcription, these viruses, they convert their nucleic acid RNA into DNA. So here in the second picture, I have shown you the structure of the bacteriophages. What are these bacteriophages? These bacteriophages are actually the viruses which infect the bacteria. When these viruses, they attach themselves with the wall of the bacterial cell, they causes the lysis of the bacterial cell. They incorporate via nucleic acids into the bacterial cell and attaches its nucleic acid with the bacterial nucleic acid. So later the bacteria is forced to produce more and more viral particles, and in this way they cause the lysis of the bacterial cell. Okay student, here the third type of microorganisms are the fungi. So these fungi we can easily culture in our lab conditions. So they are also playing some important role for human welfare. So here some of the fungi are edible in nature. We eat these fungi. They may be mushrooms. They may be some delicate fungi, delicacy fungi that are found in our food. So here we are going to study their roles, that is for the betterment of the human beings. Okay, student, first topic that I am going to start here is microbes and their role in the production of household products. Student, you are always taking curd in your breakfast. So this curd is available to you because of a microorganism, a bacterium which is known as lactobacillus. And this lactic acid bacteria, it grows in the milk and it converts the milk into curd. So during growth, what happens? These lactic acid bacteria, they produce lactic acid, they coagulate and partially digest the milk proteins. And as a result, what happens? Lactic acid is produced. So as you know, millions of these lactic acid bacteria, they are present in the curd. So it increases the nutritional quality of this curd as compared to milk by increasing more and more content of vitamin B12. And in the stomach, it is also playing one of a beneficial role, that these lactic acid bacteria, they are checking the growth of other disease causing microbes. And in this way, they make our stomach free from any kind of ailment or infection. Okay, students, sometimes we are eating a very tasty food, some South Indian food like idli and dosa. So these are the fermented type of food, and the bacteria, they are playing important role in this fermentation. So the puffed appearance of this dough for idli and dosa is due to the production of carbon dioxide gas. So dough that is used for making bread, it is also fluffy in nature because of the fungus, that is yeast fungi, and it is also called as Saccharomyces cerevisiae. A different type of traditional drinks and foods that are used in South India are also fermented by these microbes. And one of such a drink is the toddy drink, which is a famous drink of South Indian people. And it is obtained by the fermentation of sap of the palms. And later this drink is obtained by microorganisms. Then microorganisms, they are also used to ferment fish, soya bean and bamboo shoots to make food. Different variety of cheese is characterized by the characteristic texture, flavor and taste because of the specific type of microorganisms which make these cheese. For example, a very good quality cheese known as a Swiss cheese have large holes in it. And that is due to the production of large amount of carbon dioxide by a bacterium, and its name is Propionibacterium charmani. There is another kind of cheese known as Roquefort cheese. And this Roquefort cheese have a specific type of taste. And this cheese gets ripened by growing a specific fungi over it. And because of the growth of this fungi over this cheese, the cheese have a particular flavor. Okay, student, the picture of different type of things are available to you. You see curd, then idli and dosa, then we have toddy drink, then we have fermented fish, then this is the Roquefort cheese, then we have fermented bamboo shoots, and this is the Swiss cheese. So there are big holes in both of these cheese because of the production of carbon dioxide gas by the microorganism. This Roquefort cheese have a special taste because of growth of specific type of fungi over it. This is the totiary. Okay, student, microbes, they are also playing very important role in industries also. In beverage industries and in the production of antibiotics, different type of microorganisms, they are involved. For example, production on a large scale, it requires microorganisms in very, very large vessels. And these are the fermenters. These are the steel vessels, fermenters, where we put ton of raw material and inoculum in the form of microbes. And these microbes, they convert the raw material into the respective product. So various type of alcoholic beverages, such as wine, beer, whiskey, brandy, and rum, all of these, they are produced with the help of the unicellular fungus yeast, which is Saccharomyces cerevisiae. Saccharomyces cerevisiae is also used for making bread. That's why it is commonly called as brewer's yeast. Okay, student, in industries, this yeast is used for fermenting malted cereals and fruit juices. And as a result, ethanol are produced, which is the absolute alcohol. The type of the raw material used and how much distillation is done. On the basis of that, we obtain different type of alcoholic drinks here. If we are talking about wine and beer, then they are without distillation. And if we are talking about whiskey, brandy, and rum, then they are produced by more distillation of the fermented fruit. So their effect is also more as compared to wine and beer. Okay, student, what are antibiotics? Antibiotics, they are the special type of chemicals or drugs which are obtained with the help of microorganisms. So here I have written the definition. The chemical substances which are produced by some microorganisms and can kill and retard, or you can say slow down, the growth of other microorganisms, they are known as antibiotics. So these antibiotics, they are very important type of drugs that cure us from various type of dreadful diseases. So the incidence of discovery of antibiotics was first done by the scientist Alexander Fleming accidentally. What Fleming did at that time, he is doing the culture of a staphylococci bacterium. And what he observed, the bacterium, it forms the colonies over the petri plate. But there is some place where the bacteria is not able to continue their colonies. So he took the sample from that particular place and found that these bacteria, they are not growing because of the presence of a mold which is growing over that area. And that mold is actually a fungi. And that is Penicillium notatum. And from this Penicillium notatum, he isolated penicillin, which is a drug. So in this way, he is able to find out that there are certain microorganisms which are the enemies of other microorganisms. And they are producing certain chemicals to inhibit the growth of other microorganisms. So if we use these chemicals, we isolate these chemicals and we produced it on large scale in some host, we can obtain their commercial production in tons. So in this way, we can make medicines for various types of diseases that are caused by these microorganisms. So here I have written that these antibiotics, they greatly improve our capacity to treat deadly diseases such as plague. You remember very well, once upon a time in Surat, plague is spread in India and so many people, they died out of this disease. Whooping cough, which is known as Kali Khansi, and diphtheria is another bacterial disease. Leprosy, which is known as Kushth Rog, and it is caused by the bacterium Clostridium leprae. So all of these diseases, in the earlier times, they killed millions of people over the globe. But after the discovery of these antibiotics by the scientist Alexander Fleming, and two more scientists, that is Florey and Chain. They are also playing an important role in the production of these drugs. And later, all the three scientists, they are awarded with Nobel Prize after the successful use of these antibiotics in treating many soldiers, American soldiers, which get injured after World War II. So for their contribution, these three scientists, they were awarded with Nobel Prize. Okay, student, here you can see the picture of these antibiotics. So we cannot imagine our life in today's world without these antibiotics. So all of these antibiotics are actually obtained by us because of these microorganisms. So we cannot say that microorganisms or microbes, they are always pathogenic in nature. But they are also playing a very beneficial role in human life. They are working for human welfare, students. So here in this chapter, we will study later about more important roles and functions that are played by these microorganisms. So that's all in today's lecture, students. Have a nice day.